What's going on there, YouTube? I recorded this video like 5 times while I was driving today, and it came really, really long and boring, so I'm going to try to chop it down. But I did learn one thing, that if I do get a camera set up and talk while I'm driving, there are going to be some long videos. The day started early, 4:30 a.m. I woke up, left from just inside Kentucky towards Tennessee, 6 miles from Tennessee's border. Dropped off at Murfreesboro early. It's like 7 something. I left there, I think. Got my next load to pick up in Brownsville, Tennessee, and head to Orlando, Florida. So, kind of looking forward to that. Florida was rough the last time I was there, so you know, battle the demons, I guess. But was leaving, I left Brownsville, stopped at the TA to get my load scaled. It's like 11 miles away. And then kept on going. I was going south on US 45 through Tennessee and come around a little corner. Johnny Law is sitting there in the middle. I'm going by him, and I see his headlights kick on. I'm like, oh, I guess he's ready to roll out. And the cherry's popped off, and he whips in. I'm like, oh, man. So I think really quick. I'm like, wait, I'm going 57 miles an hour. I'm prime. You know, I never worry about this stuff. What am I talking about? So I'm like, oh, he's going to get that guy in front of me that's apparently going faster than I think he is. And then, you know, after a couple seconds, he's still behind me. Like, oh, really? But a level 3 inspection, doing random inspections or whatever, trying to get that paper, trying to hustle us, trying to catch us riding dirty, as the young folks say. Those of you who don't know, level 3 inspection, you give them your driver's license, medical card, logbook, truck insurance, truck registration, trailer registration, and bills. I'm pretty sure that's it. And it was all good, so I made $25 from Prime for passing an inspection. Level 3, I mean, I didn't really have anything to do with it, you know, I just handed him all the papers. You know, so it's good to make sure you're up to date. Being a company driver, the company, you know, takes care of registrations and all that. I just need to know where it is and how to get it, and you know, be aware of it, you know, making sure it's legal and all that. You know, so that's what it is. If you don't know, driver's license and medical card will be on your person at all times. Truck insurance information and truck registration is in your permit book, which they give you, which I'm sitting in the cab. It's up front, but it's a little binder, zip-up binder, and it has all your permits, you know, so you can carry liquor and just random crap for different states. But you'll get asked for that from time to time. I know the change of the year, going through Arizona, the port of entry or something, they pulled everybody in. You had to go in with your permit book and give them the first couple pages or something like that. I don't remember. But it's stuff you get asked for, so knowing where it is good. Trailer registration is on your trailer, on the nose of your trailer, right under the reefer in the middle. There's a tube with rubber stoppers on the end. I'd assume it's the same place for dry van, just except it's... there's no reefer above it. Flatbed, I think it's like tucked under one of the front corners. Don't quote me on that because I'm not sure. Tankers, I have no idea. I would assume it's somewhere up towards the front, obviously. Logbooks, I didn't have a logbook because I'm on e-logs. So I told him that, and he asked me how many hours I had left. I told him I had 5 hours, it's no big deal or whatever. no idea what would have happened if I was, like, you know, really short on hours. If they, you know, just be like, oh, all right, well, we'll get you next time or something. You know, I don't know. Doubtful, because they're trying to get that money. But you do have to have a paper logbook just in case your e-log, your Qualcomm goes down. I didn't show it to him, but I have, I think, two books of it, and then I got some random loose leaf that I got, excuse me, for trip planning and stuff like that. I think that's it. Bill of lading, you get, you know, those are your bills that you get from the shipper to take to the receiver. I guess if you're empty, you just tell them you're empty. I always kind of wondered that, but haven't encountered it. But yeah, it was crazy. I was nervous as hell. But I knew, obviously, like I said before, being with Prime, I don't really get nervous or anything when I see the cops in the middle of the road, like, waiting. Because I know I'm not speeding. I'm not speeding unless they're going down a hill and I'm not paying attention or something. Not paying attention is like it's a long downhill and you're slowly building up speed. Not like I'm flying down a hill paying no attention to anything. No, get me wrong, get me twisted up right there. And then I just picked up a trailer, so I checked all my lights and everything, so I knew, you know, it shouldn't be a light problem. You know, it shouldn't be anything as far as appearance of the truck or moving violations or anything. I was in my lane, you know, nobody was around, anything like that. But, you know, you gotta be highway. I pulled over, kept calm. One rule of thumb, there are two groups of people you never, 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 never mess with. You should already know this, but if you don't, I will hip you on a lesson right now. Police, food service workers. You never know what they're doing to your food back behind the kitchen doors, so always treat them well. And cops can royally screw you if you're rude to them. I mean, they screw you just for the hell of it, but just a rule of thumb, always be polite, courteous, and everything to those guys. I'd say do it to everybody, really. You know, I don't understand why people are so rude assholes to each other all the time. But, you know, it's your life. But, I mean, cops and food service workers always treat with respect. So, you know, as cop walked up, I asked him how he's doing, really polite, everything, you know. Made sure he was alright. You know, when he came back with the paperwork, he motioned like he would put the trailer registration. I was, no, I'll take care of it. You got stuff to do, you know. Just always be courteous. It's pretty much common sense, but there's so many dicks in the world. Shit. All day on the CB, you just hear people being rude to each other and trying to fight each other. I don't understand it. Like, the world is crazy. You know, can't y'all just get along? But hey, live your life the way you want to. But, you know, I do what I can. But yeah, that was today. Then I drove another couple hundred miles, maybe. Nah, about 100, 150, 200, almost. Another couple hours at least. Shut down here in Decatur, Alabama. I'm asleep until I get up in the morning. I don't have to deliver this load until like 11 on Sunday or Monday. And I'm 600 miles away. It's Friday night. So, I mean, I got all day. I mean, two full days of driving, which will knock that out easy. I mean, I can probably get there tomorrow. Tomorrow I'll find out if they take early deliveries. I mean, if not, I'll coast, chill. I mean, I'm not going to push myself. I'm tired. But, you know, a lot of those videos the past couple weeks have been down. But, you know, it's just a string of bad luck. And just the whole rookie syndrome. You know, it's tough out here when you start. You know, and then you add the mechanical crap that I've had to deal with. It's just rough. You know, I'm just trying to get comfortable with driving in general, and then having to add random stuff like that on it. It's just a pain. but I mean, it is what it is. The last couple of days, I've been loving it. You know, it's been simple. Get up and go, get my load, start going on it, drop it off, get the next one, go, get the next one, go, get the next one, go. I mean, you know, my dispatcher keeps us running. You know, there's almost always, you know, a load coming, you know, right when you drop that last one off, you know. As much as that's great, sometimes I don't want to run that hard. But, you know, you don't run that hard, you don't get paid as much, you know, so it's a balancing act. But, you know, building the stamina and all that stuff up, you know, it's all good. So, you know, probably won't make as many videos when everything's going well, you know, because there's nothing to complain about, there's nothing to talk about. If you have suggestions, like always, comment, Facebook group, email, whatever. Plenty of ways to ask the questions. I can't respond to questions again. YouTube is just messed up. Maybe it's YouTube mobile. I don't know. But I do everything on my phone, so that's, you know, my options. But somebody asked on the last video, maybe two videos ago, something. When do I think I'll be getting in a full-size truck? Honestly, I don't think it'll happen unless I leave Prime, become a lease driver, or become a trainer. I don't really have any reason other than this little ass truck to leave Prime. I mean, they've been good. You know, I don't have any complaints about them at all. I'd like a faster truck, but it is what it is. You know, it's not really a big deal. This tiny truck sucks. You know, you got a big bag of dirty clothes because you've been out here rolling so hard. And there's my storage up there. Where am I going to put dirty clothes? So, I mean, that's going to take a big spot right down there on the floor where I already got all kinds of other crap, all these chains I got to carry, yada, yada, yada. Nice if I had that cabinet sitting right there. And on top of that, the TV was sitting. And on top of that, I had some clothes, and I had some clothes over here. You know, yeah, it'd be awesome. But, you know, it is what it is. Maybe at some point, but I mean, I'm making good money. I can't really complain. Home time would be nice to get more of at some point. So maybe, in a year or so, I'll explore options as far as that goes. Prime is pretty much all over the road. Not much in the way of dedicated, regional, anything like that. So. Unless you're in the Northeast, I think they can keep you pretty much located in the Northeast. Gotta keep me the fuck away from the Northeast. I don't want anything to do with that. Midwest, West Coast, and the South, I'm cool with. Northeast, it's pretty up there, man. Driving through New York with the when it was fall, the trees are changing colors. Man, it was beautiful. There's no parking. There's too many people. Most of them are rude and can't drive. You know, so I was he gives some regional people that stuff. But this video's going on. I was about to kick it off 3 minutes ago. Nothing else going on. I got a couple thoughts for other videos. I'll try to do them maybe at some point. I don't know. But yeah, you know, that's really all this going on. So keys to what you learned today is be nice to cops and know where your paperwork is and pre-trip. So on that note, I will leave y'all and maybe I'll take some video, hopefully from sunny, bright and warm. Maybe I will be wearing some shorts in Florida. So y'all be safe, be blessed. Hopefully it is not too cold where you are. It probably is, but you know, out of my hands. Sorry. Later. When I push stop and it doesn't.